It's that time. Welcome to Roadmap. How to take 3 listings a week until you're ready for more. And it's another Tesla show. This week, we're driving up to Chicago, Illinois, in the beautiful suburbs of Orland Park, where we'll find Mr. James Mattz. James has taken several years to become an overnight sensation. We have several agents coming with us from Cincinnati at the local Keller Williams office who's decided to go up and shadow Mr. James Mattz and learn what he is doing. And it's going to be a real treat. James can set 2 or 3 appointments in one day. One day he can set that many appointments. So we're going to see it in action, folks. Here, enjoy the ride.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Very well.
It's a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you for having us. Very excited.
James, good to see you.
Good to see you again, buddy. Man, you look like you're getting younger.
Amy. Don't encourage him.
Oh, you know what?
Nice to meet you too, James.
Thank you.
Good morning, I'm Erin.
I'm Erin. That's a pretty name.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Susie. Thanks so much for having us.
It's a pleasure meeting you.
Hi, James. I'm Jeff. It's a pleasure to meet you today.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Awesome.
So by 2009, my 20-year marriage collapsed.
Oh,
so
my gosh.
Sick dad,
wow.
Sick mom.
One more thing.
The business is at a ferocious roller coaster down.
Yeah.
And now my marriage crashed. So the only thing I knew to do, or what to do, that I had comfort in, you know, like the blanket and the Snoopy character,
yeah,
or whatever. My
blanket.
was lead generation. That's what I could depend on. And so when I was listing, 18 to 30 properties every 30 days, it went to 7 to 10 properties every 30 days. So lead generation basically saved my life.
Mm-hmm.
That's sort of been my philosophy.
You and Gary Keller.
Yeah, yeah.
How many hours you told me you calculated that you've lead generated?
I've lead generated, Gary says 10,000 hours, mm-hmm, is mastery level.
Mm-hmm.
And I sort of went back and counted, and I got 26,664 hours of lead generation time in.
And change.
Yeah.
And change.
How many hours a day do you spend lead generating?
Every day from 8:30 to noon, and that was happy. My team doesn't bother me, no one. My pastor, my best friend, my fiance, everybody knows you can't talk to me during that time.
Yeah. So we need to hear you do some of this lead generation?
Yeah, why don't we? Why don't we?
Awesome.
Why don't we? I'll just pull up my stuff here. Please do that, and you have the number, right? Well, that's what I'm looking at. Well, I tell you what, I'm going to be in that area on appointments on Thursday of this week and Saturday of next week. What would be a good day for me to stop out and take a look at it? No, I'll be in that area on this Thursday and this Saturday. Which day would be good for me to stop out and take a look at it? On Thursday. Okay, I tell you what, can I stop out and take a look at it on Thursday? Let's see, why don't we say about 4 o'clock? Yeah. Okay, now let me ask you a question. I see that when it came off the market, you were asking right at 219, right? What would you say is your bottom line price? Okay, alrighty. And of course, I see that the property has been totally renovated. Is there any remaining work that you need to do, or it's ready for occupancy right now? Now, when I come out on Thursday, if I could show you not only of our ability to get this property under contract, but most importantly, at a price that get you guys the dollars you're looking to net out. Could you see yourself working with us? Okay, great. All right, fantastic. Well, thank you so much for giving me a moment of your time, and I look forward to our conversation on Thursday afternoon being the best one of the day. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.
I love that he says that.
I didn't like them. They were too dark. You could tell that they weren't professional. It wasn't a professional photographer. It was probably their camera phone. I mean, it's just a whole host of things that you'll have the opportunity to see once we get together tomorrow morning, and you will find the value that you have been looking for and that you deserve. Our rate is negotiable. One of the most important things about a real estate transaction is the dollars that comes to that title company. The most important dollars are the ones that go in your pocket. So I want to definitely have an understanding of that, and we'll work around that. Wouldn't that be great? Fantastic. Well, listen, thank you so much. And I'm going to assume your first name is Lori, right? Okay, Lori. Well, thank you so much. And I look forward to our conversation tomorrow morning being the best one of the day. And look for the email I'm going to send you. You're welcome. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.
That was a good one.
That was a good one.
I really, really. So you squeezed that one in there.
Yeah, because she was talking to two people. She ain't talking to nobody. Blah, 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 blah.
I really like that. And I really like, because she questioned your commission, didn't she?
Yeah, she did.
And then you. That was good.
How long did it take you to become an overnight sensation?
About 30 years.
There we go.
That's 26,000 hours at work.
Should I take the grand tour?
Yeah, absolutely.
This is the culmination of 15 years, starting in a 1,500 square foot space with 10 of us, and then building to a 5,000 square foot space, then practically bankrupting the whole thing and being $300,000 in the hole, then moving the office 20 miles west, and we were in 6,500 square feet. We started there, we were in a space, it was 6,500 square feet, but we only had half of it. We split it with a mortgage company, and we had 45 agents. And we stayed in that space, kicked out the mortgage company eventually, built that up to about 350, I think it was, agents, wow. And then we moved over here. So really, yeah, it's been quite a journey.
Yeah.
And so this is the culmination of that. I don't know if you want to walk through.
Yeah, this is a great space.
Take a look around last night.
You do your bolds here?
We do the bolds right in the building. Yep.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes, of course we have a bold wall.
Yeah, great.
And then I can show you where my team is back here if you'd like.
Yeah, this is super.
So, go ahead.
What do we do? We list 10 homes, sell 10 homes, and close 10 homes each and every week. And we list 10 homes, sell 10 homes, and close 10 homes each and every week. Yes!
If someone isn't here, they have my phone, so they can still report it.
As long as I've known Ron, he's always worked hard, and he's had an exciting life. He's never been always on real estate or always on in life. It's you've manage that well.
I like to play.
Yeah, I know. But he would. But and the secret was, as you explained it a long time ago, was that when you're on, you're getting all this stuff done, and you had it in this tight box. Whereas most agents spread it out to here.
Yeah.
But they're not as efficient in this time, so they're working long days. Yeah. Sometimes a lot of the weekend, because they didn't do what they're supposed to do in this. And you've always packed it in tight.
Hardcore, just what I want them to do too, right? It's like, if you have an 8-hour work day, freaking work your 8-hour work day, right? Don't goof off for 4 of the hours and then you're home and you're miserable because your production's down and you're not doing well, but really it's because you didn't work when you were supposed to work.
Right, and most, that is a big challenge for most people out there.
We're very good about space, as in, so that's Colleen's desk, and the other half of her desk is one of her assistants.
Gotcha. That's awesome.
And, yeah, we're pretty hardcore.
Is that good?
This is fantastic.
Thank you.
Yeah, this is super. Great. Thanks for having us.
You can kind of take a peek into the future, what it can be like.
Absolutely.
I use a combination.
Okay, custom.
But yet, the key thing, and I think what Ren was sharing, is it's all about the questions.
Right.
Always asking questions, because that's what keeps it about them as opposed to about getting a listing.
Exactly.
Kind of thing.
And that's what they're going to take from that. Right. You're going to be unlike any other agent they've come in contact with.
Right.
See, people don't smile enough. You got to smile a lot, particularly when you're talking and you're making a point with them, and then you get to the thing you want them to do, and you're smiling at them, kind of thing, and so forth. Those are the small things that really make a difference. Because at the end of the day, people do business with people that they can trust.
Interesting is you'll sit there and you'll call a handful of numbers, and you'll get through and have a conversation with them, while there are people that are regular people will call that same list and get a goose egg. Every day they'll get a goose egg.
Yes.
So what are the little things that you're
going?
Well,
the difference is
in my voice inflection, and a lot of people are robotic with the scripts.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Hi, my name is John Doe, and I see that your home came off the market. When do you plan on interviewing the right agent that can get it sold for you?
Sell your house.
And when you get that script from several people, it's like click, click, you know, kind of thing. Good morning. This is James Mattz following back up regarding the property on 74th Street. I've left a couple messages, and of course, I'm really hoping that I have an opportunity to share some very powerful information regarding the buyer pool that is interested in this property on 74th Street. If you can give me a call at your earliest opportunity, 708-249-3160, I think we could create a timing situation where buyer interest and the availability of this property could really prove to create a sales scenario pretty quickly. Thank you, and I look forward to speaking with you very, very soon. Please give me a call, 708-249-3160. Hey, Ms. Granger. Hi, James Mattz, Keller Williams. Good morning. Good. I went ahead and I did some analysis on that property, and I got to tell you, I was really encouraged based on some of the market data that I looked at. And let me ask you, are you available either tomorrow evening or Saturday afternoon? Truly, that's where the results reside, Ms. Ranger. It's in the strategy and in the execution of it. And so those are the tidbits that we'll be presenting and going over point by point. Yeah, the biggest difference is how we're going to create the offers. See, the key thing is if you get it in the offer scenario, that puts you in a position to negotiate it to the acceptable price. If you don't get any offers, guess what you have? Absolutely. So my strategy that I'm going to share with you on Monday afternoon is exactly how we're going to create the offers. And then once we create the offers, I'm going to show you how we're going to be able to negotiate it to the acceptable price. And that's the key difference in the strategy that you haven't seen, but you know, it's something that's unique to our approach to the business, which really represents our value and our competitive difference in the marketplace. So I'm just so excited about showing you guys exactly how it works. You know, it's just like when you think about great athletes. Mm-hmm. I don't know, you guys are from Ohio. Mm-hmm. I know you guys gotta love Ohio State.
Right.
Oh, Cleveland. Oh, Cleveland, Ohio is getting ready. I mean, they just got AB.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm a New England fan and have been for many years.
I liked
many
you.
Many years, yeah, many years.
Of many all the years. Teams, you're gonna say that yeah. you love it.
But the thing is when you think about Brady, the Lewis guy that was a linebacker from the Ravens said this. He said, if you're gonna beat Brady, you better be in a room. He says Brady gets in a room on a small TV, and he sits in the room for 8 hours at a time, and he has a clicker, and he's got the TV and the tape, and he's clicking, you know, clicking it frontwards, backwards, letting the play out backwards. He's doing that for 8 hours a day. He said, if you're going to beat Brady, you better be clicking more than him.
Yeah, right.
And the thing is, in our business, our skill is built on the rapport that we make with our clients. And so, from a listing standpoint, if you are lead generating on a daily basis and really understanding, just like an athlete, just like shooting 1,000 jumpers or in the weight room, or on the track and jogging, boxers, they're running for miles and miles. If we're really willing to pay the cost to perfect our skills, to get our body and our mind and our mouth working in unison, you know, being able, like a great singer, you like great singers, how they get on the mic and they just do things that just tug on your heart. Well, we can have that same type of skill set. And what we do is just like what I did today. And of course, I was a little bit more demonstrative because I wanted you guys to really get a pulse of what I do every day. But I really get into it. And I set 4 appointments. And if I could set 4 or 5 appointments every day, you know, all I want to do in life is I just want to put 7 figures in my pocket.
Yeah,
that's all I want to do.
But it's what it's not even the money. It's what the money will do for you. And others.
Exactly. I've driven every car. I've had every outfit. I've been to most places. I got a grandson now.
Aww.
And I think about being in my summer place or on the West Coast and him being, you know, waddling in the pool with me.
How old is he?
He's 7 months.
Aww.
Yeah.
That's
awesome. He's 7 months and I got a, you know, I mean, he's a.
Does he live out there? Here.
He lives here,
okay.
But this kid is.
Where's your place out there?
In Palm Desert.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah.
Now you can't tell me that this kid.
I know how you discovered Palm Desert.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, so cute! Look at his cheeks.
Oh my gosh! And that hat—it's like 5.
Oh, look at that! Look at that!
Adorable.
Yeah, I'm getting him in the hats already.
Love it.
That's what I live for now.
Yeah.
Thank you guys.
It's down to best practices, doesn't it?
It is.
And for the group that came up to shadow you, it's for them, it's, you know, not only what to say, but how to say it.
Exactly.
How to communicate with people, yes, at a much higher level.
Yes.
So you can set 4 appointments in a day, which for, yeah, most people is unheard of. Most agents will call those same people,
mm-hmm,
and set 0.
Right.
Today.
Right.
I think there's a perception when you're hearing about someone's success in lead generation that it's real easy for them and it must be different when they're doing it.
Right.
And then when you see that, oh yeah, 5 people won't answer their phone for James either.
Right.
It's not just me.
Exactly.
There's, I think, kind of a transference of power almost that, oh, I can actually do this. The same things happen. If I can skill up, I'll get the same results.
Right.
Makes a big difference.
That's it, Sarah. That's it. So something about shadowing,
right,
is so much different than hearing it on a stage,
yeah,
reading it online.
Right.
You know, but when you see it, your belief system goes up so much higher.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
And you, the part that, like, I can do this.
Right. Yeah, they got some guys that, Chris Soares. Is that his name?
Yeah, Soares.
And I want to I want to spend some time. He's a interesting guy. He talked about, I went to his CEO breakout session to a family reunion. And he talked about the fact that he reads a book a week. That was just such an incredible aha. I love to read. Yet, when you're working, until 7, 8, 9 at night and get home at 9:30, 10 at night, and you wanna eat, you wanna unwind, and next thing you know, it's 12 o'clock, it's time to go to bed to get ready for the next day.
Right.
Yeah. So he talked about you gotta have, as a CEO mindset, you gotta have 2 hours of white space in your 8-hour day.
Yeah.
You gotta make that part of your day.
Right.
That CEO time, that reading time, and that's foreign to me. I'm going to take 2 hours to read a book on leadership when I can be getting some listings. It's just a different way of thinking, but it forces you to think from a perspective of how a CEO is not going on the listing appointment.
No,
but the CEO is definitely very, very aware of how many listings his business needs.
Right.
That's
exactly right.
Put it in the schedule.
Yep. Have to put it in the schedule, but you have to, I tell people all the time, they marvel at some of the incredible things that Lance does, but it's something Lance said to me at a years ago, and I asked him, what were some of the, how did you overcome the times in your career and building your business when things didn't go the way you thought, and when you did have failure? I wanted to know, because that was at that time, that was where I was. How do I overcome the fact that I'm at the bottom and I been up to the mountain and looked up over yonder? How do I come back, from despair and defeat and all those kinds of things? And he said this to me. He said it to the room. He started talking about he was building his business, and he was down to his last 50,000. And he put it into some type of radio, TV, something, some big program he was doing, and it didn't work. And he was telling me about, his house being behind, language that I could understand.
Uh-huh.
And then he told me that he kept plowing in the lead generation, and inevitably he got that boomerang, but people don't realize that he had put $250,000 into his business before he started making any money. Well, nobody talks about that.
Yeah.
That's not fun to talk about.
I know. The lead gen will save you when you the market start turning on you.
It was the lead gen that really saved me.
Yeah.
Really kept some revenue stream coming through my hands.
And if you look at all the people that are still in the business that were in the business prior to that, those are the ones that probably did a lot of lead gen.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Those are the ones that survived.
Mm-hmm. That's it.
I like that analogy of the blanket. That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
You have full control of it.
That's right. I really like this car, man. It rides like an SUV.
They're nice. Alrighty. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Really a pleasure.
It's mine.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I appreciate you a lot.
I really appreciate you coming out, man, and hanging out with me and having fun. This was great.
Thank you.
Thanks for being here for another Roadmap Tesla show. What a powerful show. Sarah Close got to shadow Ron Wexler and his office operation and learn from that. Her agents got to shadow Mr. James Mattz and watch him take set four listing appointments. He said four. Can you imagine that? What an exciting time. You should shadow somebody. and learn from them. Find a city 4 hours away, drive there or fly to some city and shadow a top person, learn from them and come back. As you know, we simulcast the show on the Lead Gen Facebook group. I want to thank them and Aaron Wittenstein, who runs it. If you want to get involved with the Lead Gen Facebook group, they have 50,000 members. They're at facebook.com/groups/gotobjections. And Aaron runs a great program called trajectorynow.com. And finally, if you're watching on Facebook and you're not yet involved with Vulcan 7, make sure to sign up at vulcan7.com/lead gen for a special deal. So remember the power of shadowing. And today was a great example. Have a great week, everybody. See you next week.